guys, can you let me know if you can all hear me? Hey guys, I think I'm live right now. Let me know if any of you guys can hear me. Just type something. Say, yes, I can hear you, Mona. Okay, great. Hi, Kim. How are you guys all doing? Today is what? Saturday night. Okay, perfect. Thanks, Sandra. I'm glad you guys can hear me. How are you guys doing tonight? I'm looking forward to doing this. So I was kind of going back and forth about what exactly I should do for tonight's live stream. So I thought, why not do like a get ready with me using all new luxury makeup products? Well, there's a couple things that are not new, but for the most part, all of them are pretty much new. So, and then of course, if you guys have any sort of questions or anything like that, you're more than welcome to ask me while we're doing the live stream and while I'm kind of like doing my makeup. So, all right, so the first thing, so what I did was I basically put everything in this Charlotte Tilbury box to kind of like make sure I have everything that I need to do my makeup. Hopefully, I think I have everything. Hi, Estella, how are you? So I got a sample of something that I've been wanting to try. Okay, what is it? You know that Sisley primer that like everybody on YouTube was talking about a while back? And it's like $200 or something, and they're like, it's the most. Hi, Nadia. Nadia, how are you? So I wanted to go ahead and give this a try. So I actually got a sample of it. And it was so funny. Like when the lady, she didn't even know about this particular primer, the one who was filling it up. She doesn't work. She works at the Tom Ford counter. And she was like, oh, what's the big deal about this? And I was like, I don't know. I need to find out. So she actually gave me a pretty generous sample. So I'm going to start with that and just kind of dot it all over my face. And I have a mirror here, so just keep that in mind if you're wondering why she's looking over there. Let me try to angle it so you guys can actually see me better. Hang on a second. All right. So let me just rub this in real quick. So it has like a very silicone-y feel. Smells pretty good. You are the one who introduced me to Charlotte Tilbury. Oh, this, you know what? A lot of people tell me that. They're always like, you're the reason why I have all the Charlotte Tilbury stuff, which is like awesome. Because I'm such a huge fan of Charlotte Tilbury. Hi, Viviana. How are you? Okay, so it does have a tacky feeling. All right, so this is that Sisley primer that everybody like talks about. Okay, so I'm gonna show you guys this new foundation that I've been using, and I have a video that I should be posting up sometime next week. Have you guys heard of Laura Mercier's new foundation? This is the Flawless Lumiere Radiance Perfecting Foundation. Oh, don't mind Daisy, she's down there. Have you guys seen this foundation yet? You are a Charlotte Tilbury brand ambassador in my point of view. You know what? I would love to be her brand ambassador for like the US, you know, and like you have no idea how much work it was to get on her PR team because her PR team is pretty difficult to get on. But luckily I like made myself noticeable enough and I like was persistent enough and I know enough people who work for her that I was able to do that. But their PR team a lot of times does not have any sort of PR samples for American viewers or bloggers. For some reason, their like budget for America is like not, they basically don't need to really advertise too much in America because Americans love her stuff. It's more like in the other countries that I notice. I know, right? That would be great if you could vote for me. I'm slightly lighter than you. Which Charlotte Bronze and Bright should I try? I would try the light medium. I'm wanting to travel 6 hours when you have your CT meet and greet. Oh, that's so sweet. So have you guys, any of you guys heard about this foundation yet? The new Laura Mercier Foundation? Flawless Lumiere Radiance Perfecting. Like, honestly, you guys, I've been using this now for 2 weeks now, and I really, really like, hi, Michelle! Oh, yeah, you guys, after my live stream, you got to go to Michelle's channel because she's doing a live stream too. So just keep that in mind. So we're kind of like back-to-back live streaming, you guys. And so make sure to check out her channel too afterwards. That's my girl, man. That's my homie. I love her so much. All right, so I'm going to start with the foundation. And then I have like a damp beauty blender. So I usually use like 3 pumps. You might, oh yeah, girl. Michelle and I have this like awesome like relationship. We really, really, truly like are really good friends. And like we both like are very supportive of each other. We both are like, that's my Judy. Right, Michelle? You're my Judy. For those of you who don't know, Judy means like my bestie, my like best, my good friend, my homie. Yes, back-to-back live streams, you guys. Saturday night with Mona Khan and Michelle Wong. So I'm just going to bounce this in. And like, oh, in case you guys are wondering, I am in the shade 3N1 Buff. You are my Judy girl. And I'm sure all of you guys are already subscribed to Michelle. So I wouldn't be surprised that you, after you're done here, just go head on over to her channel and watch her video or watch her live stream. I think, what are you doing today, Michelle? You're doing like what we want to see in 2019 or something. What is it that you are going to be talking about in your live stream today? I think it's something a little bit different. I mean, I really, 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 really like this foundation a lot. It like, do you guys see that? It's just so like radiant, like off the bat. So right now I'm in a like phase where all I want to do is wear radiant foundation. So new releases answering any question. I missed while I was on vacation. Nothing earth shattering. Yeah, but like new releases, like what's new right now is what some people, a lot of people like to talk about. And then they kind of want to have an idea of whether or not, you know, it's something that you would be interested in getting. So, oh, by the way, Michelle, real quick question. I didn't watch this your sleeve video yet. Is that a thumbs up or a thumbs down with the Sicily foundation? I haven't had a chance to watch the video yet. Okay, so that's that foundation. I really, really like it a lot. Yeah, Eminem live streams. There you go. That should be our catchphrase. Thank you, NK. That should totally be our catchphrase. Thank you for that. Thumbs up. Oh, awesome. Okay, you guys, you heard it here. In case you did not get a chance to watch Michelle's video yet on the new Sicily, I think it's a cushion foundation. It's a thumbs up, so it's supposed to be really good, which is really good because the La Mer one ended up not being as good. So the Sicily one's supposed to be good. So look out for that. And then, let's see, what else do I have here? Okay, so I have been using this every day now. This is not new though, but this is the Giorgio Armani Maestro Color Corrector and the Apricot one. So I literally use this every single day because I have, so the thing about these dark like circles, they're not really dark circles, it's a shadow. So if I was to go like this, look, it's gone. Isn't that crazy? Look, it's actually gone when you press. Are you getting any new Tom Ford quads? They are very pretty. Yes, I actually have a new Tom Ford quad to do makeup with today. Yeah, so don't worry, Nadia, I got you there. Beautiful and dry. Yeah, shade range sucks. Yep. All right, so what I do with this, and that's why whenever you see people get filler underneath their under eyes to lift up the skin. So it's not really that they have an actual dark circle. It's a shadow. So I literally put this on right here to try to minimize that shadow. And I put it on like right here. And then I put it here because I have some darkness here too. I use that corrector. Yeah, I know, right? It's such a good color corrector. I thought the YSL one was good, but this is like way better. So, all right. So I just kind of like dab it in with my beauty blender. And you can automatically see right there how much it brightened up that under eye. So you can't really see that dark circle underneath. So we'll do the same thing on the other eye right here. So if you guys haven't noticed, I actually finally got my eyebrows done yesterday. So when I lived in New York, I would get my brows done religiously by this brow technician who goes, her name's Lisa, but she goes by the name Brow Bitch. So she was doing my brows for a couple years. And when I moved back to Illinois, and I'm in Central Illinois, I was really particular about who's going to be doing my brows. So I kind of was doing them myself, and I do a horrible job because I'm like, I forget, I'm lazy, I don't like groom them. Then finally I was like, hey, you know, my Ulta here has a Benefit brow bar. So I went to it, I made an appointment, and I actually like the way the girl did it. She kept it nice and thick, which is what I want. And I'm happy with it. And my face looks so much better now that my brows are done. They really are the pillars of the face. Okay, so up next, I have a new concealer that I have been using. This is the Cover FX Power Play Concealer, and I'm in the shade N Medium 2. Have any of you guys tried this particular concealer? It's a full coverage concealer. I've been using this for a few weeks now. Oh, there's cat. I have cat hair on like everything. I've been using this for a few weeks now, and I really like it a lot. I don't like it. Well, you know what? I do like it a lot. It's good. I think the Laura Mercier Flawless Fusion or Flawless Fluid Longwear one is really good too. But this one I like because it's full coverage. Oh, there's something on my face. Okay. And then I kind of just dot it like that. And I literally just put it kind of around. Have any of you guys used this one? The Cover FX Color Corrector? Or Cover FX Full Coverage, what is it called? Power Play Concealer? Okay, and then I do the same thing. I just dab this in using my Beauty Blender. You know, I haven't been using my, I like Charlotte Tilbury's New Magic Concealer. I do like it a lot, but it's not full coverage. It's more of a medium coverage foundation. So just keep that in mind. But it is a really, really good foundation. It really has a nice like stretch to it, but it's not full coverage. Okay, so that's what that concealer looks like right now. Great coverage, but weird applicator. Yeah, the applicator is a little strange. It's a little too big. I wish it was a little smaller, but the coverage is really good. And so I've been wearing it. I go back and forth with my concealers. I try different ones like all the time, depending on like my mood or depending on whatever I grab that's in front of me. Okay. So here, I got my complexion on, so I have my foundation on, I have my concealer on, and then I'm going to set my concealer. Oh, I feel like I have something itching here. Okay. I have to set my concealer, and this is my holy grail, Laura Mercier Secret Brightening Powder, and can you guys see that? I'm finally going to start using it up. I love your channel. When I watch your videos, my son says, Mom is busy watching your favorite makeup artist videos. Can you call his name just to make him happy? His name is Ibrahim Kadir. Hi, Ibrahim Kadir. Hi. Hi. Oh, my God. Greetings from Tokyo. Hey, Tokyo. What's up? Hi, Normax USA. That is so cute. Okay, so let's go ahead and set. So I'm almost done with this, which is like a miracle because I think I've had this for a few years now. All right, I feel like I have something on. Yeah, it's right here. Got it. I have something on. I had something itching. Okay, so I've just put enough underneath my under eye just to kind of set it. I don't bake. I have not been able to figure out how to bake properly. And that is okay because I'm okay with applying like a thin layer of setting powder underneath my eyes. Oh, I missed your cast. Love the collaboration with Michelle. We need another one as soon as possible. Oh, I'm going to see her, I think, in the spring. I'm going to come visit Michelle again in like the springtime, because I have to go there because I'm going to get going to a conference where I get certified in learning how to do like lip fillers and like Botox and stuff. So I definitely will be going, coming to Vegas very, very soon. Give it a couple more months. Oh, you guys want to see one of my cats? Okay, hold on. Hang on a second. Let me grab one of them real quick. This is Jasmine. Say hi, Jazz. This is Jasmine. What do you guys think? Isn't she so cute? Where you know where you want to go. So she's a Persian silver chinchilla. Isn't she so pretty? She's so cute. She's very, 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 very sweet and very loving. And she's got like, I don't know if you can see, she's a green eye. So she's like a fancy piece. What? She was like going crazy a little bit earlier, trying to like wanting me to like pet her and stuff. And now, of course, when you know how cats are, the moment you want them to do something, they're not going to do it. Okay, so I set my under eyes, and I'm just going to put a tiny bit of powder in my T-zone, just a little bit. And I'm going to use my Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Finish Skin Perfecting Micro Powder in number 2 medium, which is what I use every single day. I mean, you guys can see I've hit pan and I'm still like working it. I'm still using it. All right. So literally that's all the powder you need, because I want my foundation to look radiant. So that's all the powder I use. Hi, could you list your foundation shades and some top foundations like Michelle does in her vids? Hard to find good matches for brown girls. It would be, okay, so Charlotte Tilbury, her Magic Foundation and her Light Wonder Foundation, I'm in the shade number 7. If you like Giorgio Armani, I'm 6.5 or 7 in his foundations. And then for Laura Mercier, I'm always the shade Buff, 3N1. And then for Dior, I'm usually always 031 sand. Oh my God, did you guys see that Dior just came out with a new radiant foundation? Oh my God, I saw that and I was like, oh my God, am I gonna have to go get another foundation? Because I really, really, really like Dior's foundations. And so when I saw it on Trendmood's Instagram today, I was like, oh great, I'm gonna have to end up buying another foundation, because I really wanna try Dior's radiant. It's like the Forever foundation, but in like a radiant version, which I think would be like awesome, because that foundation is really good. Yeah, we should give it a try, Michelle. I think you should give it a try too, because I know like Dior foundations, I think you said, I don't remember, I think you said either they're like a hit or miss with you. You should give it a try, because I mean, I think it would be kind of cool, and it's like a really pretty packaging, and I think a lot of people would be interested in knowing your thoughts, because you have dry skin. I have a normal to oily skin. So there kind of be a good way for them to like figure out if it's going to be good for them based off of their skin type. And then we can kind of give them our feedback. I think that would be kind of cool. Okay, so love, you've been watching for a couple years. Hi, Freda. How are you? Okay, so I'm going to do my brows. So when I was in Vegas with Michelle, we went to the Tom Ford counter. So the Tom Ford stuff you're going to see and the Chanel stuff you're going to see is from when I went to Vegas to get rid of the fragrance. You know, I can't remember if Dior's has a fragrance. I can't remember. So one of Michelle's holy grail products is her Fibro Brow Gel. So I got it. I got it in the shade Espresso. I gave it a try and I really liked it. So one of the things that I personally like are Fibro like brow gels that I can actually use to kind of fill and fluff up and tame. So kind of like an all-in-one type of formula. So that's why I was like, you know what? I really like this. So this is what the brush looks like. So it's not like a tiny, tiny brush. It's actually pretty big. And then you just work it through. So you guys can hear Daisy right now. Oh, thank you, Ina. That's so sweet. This is the Tom Ford fiber brow gel. That's what this is. So I'm going to go ahead and apply this through my brows that I finally got done. I finally look groomed. And after I apply it, I'll show you guys. Do you see how like it right away quickly like filled everything in? Isn't that so nice? Like, that was so easy. I didn't even need to use a pencil or anything. And it makes your brows look really like full and thick, which is exactly what I'm looking for. So you guys can see that actually right there. Look at that. Like, look at the difference. I mean, this is my bad brow, but it makes that big of a difference. All right, so I'm going to apply it to the other brow. And then you guys can kind of also see what this does on this side. So this is my eyebrow that gives me problems all the time. So do you guys see that? So easy. See? That was so easy. Can you please say my name? Genevieve Ravi. Am I saying it right? Genevieve Ravi. I think sounds like an Indian name. I'm pronouncing it like an Indian, so. Okay. So you guys can see that right there. Look how easily it just kind of filled my brows. Oh, so one of the things I wanted to tell you guys completely off track. Do you see this? This is one of my subscribers. Painted this for me or made this for me. Isn't that so nice? Is this so pretty? She was asking me, so what are the kind of things that you like in art and stuff? And I was like, oh, you know, I like scenery. I like, you know, sunset. I like flowers. And so like she actually made this for me. It's so crazy. Isn't this so beautiful? I really like it a lot. So I was like, I better showcase it and show it to you guys. She's like an amazing artist. And it's so nice, and it's on like canvas and everything, and it's so fitting because I really love color and I love bright color and all like the colors of the sunrise and sunset and things like that. So I really was happy with it. It's just so pretty, and I think it's now I'm realizing it's a little off, but okay. But it's so nice. I really like it a lot. Yeah, it's really cool. So I'm really happy. Hi, Mary G. You need to add two personalized smaller ones. Yeah, you're right. I need to continue. I need to like add something here. Is the foundation full coverage? The foundation is medium to full coverage. So if I wanted to continue to build off of this, I can totally do that. So this is the Laura Mercier Flawless Lumiere Radiance Perfecting Foundation. This is her newest foundation that she came out with. And this is in 3-in-1 buff. Really, really, I've been using this for a few weeks now and I really like it a lot. Okay, so let's do eyes next. So I got the new Tom Ford Quad in Pretty Baby. So let me show it to you guys. So this is what it looks like. So here's Pretty Baby. But the thing is that I like to use a cream shadow as a base, so I'm going to use the new cream shadow that I got from Chanel as my base. This is Silver Screen. That's what this looks like. So I'm going to use that as like a base for this shadow look. And then I got the new eye pro brushes by Sonia G. So I thought, let me go ahead and pull these out and start using them now. So brand new. Question, did you guys, Michelle would probably know this. Michelle, wasn't Sonia G's new Worker 3 and Blender 3 supposed to come out today on Beautylish? Wasn't it supposed to come out today? I thought it was supposed to come out on the 22nd, and I'm pretty sure Yeah, today's the 22nd. I don't know if it like came out or is it gonna come out later? Oh, cool. Look at the way that she has it in like these Japanese like packages. Okay, so let me pull all these brushes out. I'm gonna be using those. I need to buy her face brushes. Yes, today at 10 a.m. Oh, they're already on? Hold on, guys. Let me buy something real quick. I think they're still available. They better still be available because, okay. Add to bag. Okay, cool. We're good. I'll make sure to, hi, Laura. I got beat up. Reply if you agree. Hey, girl. Okay, so let me get these brushes out. So these are the Sonia G Eye Pro. Look at these handles. So cool. Love, love, love. Okay, so I'm going to use this one first. What is this one called? Worker Pro. And I'm going to apply the cream shadow by Chanel and Silver Screen on as a base first, which is literally what I do all the time. If you want to be able to have your makeup or your eye makeup last like all day, that's the best way to do it. Just apply like a cream shadow as a base and then it'll last all day because it has something to adhere to. Okay, so okay. So I'm literally just applying it to my lid. Okay. So this is on. And then I'm going to use the Builder Pro. And then I'm going to go into this shade first. And then I'm going to apply this all over the lid, all the way up to the brow bone. All right, let me get rid of this guy. Who are you? You gotta go. Okay. How do you choose your cream base color with your powder shadows? You know what? I kind of see what color would match it, you know, if I can possibly, or I like to kind of transform colors. So I kind of worked like for this particular look, because I knew this was a cool tone, more of a cool tone look. I wanted a cool tone eyeshadow base. So that's why I used the silver one. Intimidates me. Silver intimidates me, but Chanel cream eyeshadow looks great and wearable for me. Yeah, look, you can wear silver. How long have you been doing makeup? Okay, so, ow, Jasmine, she tried to jump on me. So I have been a makeup lover since I was a kid. I remember being 8 years old, and my mom got this like huge like makeup set from Estee Lauder, and I used to go through like fashion magazines because I had two older sisters who are 6 and 7 years older than me. So they would have fashion magazines and I would go through them, and I clearly remember this. There was like a like spread that was from about Kevin Aucoin, and Kevin Aucoin did three different looks on three different women. One was like a smoky look, one was a like glam look, and then one was like a natural like everyday look. I'll never forget that. And the look that I loved was of course the smoky look. And like even as a little kid, hey, hi, how are you? Even as a little kid, that's what I was drawn to. And I remember trying to follow the tutorial and trying to do the makeup using my mom's stuff. So I've always been into makeup. I've always, since I was like 13 years old, went to like makeup shows, went to makeup events, things like that. So it's always been something that I've loved. It wasn't until, yeah, Kevin Aucoin was amazing. It wasn't until I would say 2014 when Charlotte came out with her. So I used to watch Charlotte Tilbury before she came out with her line, and I used to follow her makeup techniques. But it wasn't until I actually did a masterclass with her and where she actually taught it that I learned how to really do makeup. Mona, is Tom Ford's brow gel? No, I would say the brow gel is really good. Did you get the new Chanel lipsticks? I already had those. Those that came out recently, those came out during the Nordstrom anniversary sale. So I purchased them back in July. But the brow gel is awesome. Definitely get that. All right, so let me apply this first shade. This right here, all over the lid. It kind of like transforms the entire color, which is so cool. You see how that like went from like silver to like a purpley silver? That's really pretty. And it kind of has a pink to it too. What's your ethnicity? My parents are from India. My parents are from Hyderabad, India. So my ethnicity is Indian, but I was born and raised in Chicago, Illinois, and I've actually never been to India. So I'm like totally American. And my parents are like, do you ever want to go to India? And I'm like, no. I should, but the problem is I have really bad asthma. And my allergist is like, I don't think you can go to India. Hey girl, how are you? Hi Monica, how are you? How did you get into the beauty field? You're Muslim. Yes, I am Muslim. So those of you who are Muslim, assalamu alaikum. So I got into beauty. I've always been into beauty, and I've always had friends that were makeup artists. And so when I would always find out about makeup stuff before they would, it got to a point where a lot of my friends were like, you need to have like a blog or something, or have like a YouTube channel. So that's kind of what inspired me back in 2016 to start my channel. And I was trying to do a blog, but I realized that a blog is a lot of work to keep up with. So I decided just to do YouTube instead. Anyway, my one of the most beautiful women, love your big eyes. I feel like you don't need much to make your eyes pop. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. What is your, oh, come on. Why don't you want to visit India? Oh, it's not that it's because I have severe persistent asthma. I mean, it's well controlled right now, but my allergist told me I cannot go to India because I would get really sick. And the most east I've ever gone is Saudi Arabia. And I got really sick in Saudi Arabia, and Saudi Arabia is very, very clean. So I don't think I would be, my health wise, I would be okay in India. That's the reason why. Okay, so next up, I'm going to use her Blender Pro, and then I'm going to go into this purpley shade, and then I'm going to actually work that right into the crease. So if you're ever wondering where your crease is, keep your eye open, and that is your crease right there. Oh, wow, that color is hella pigmented. Okay. Wow, that is super pigmented. I wasn't expecting that. Okay, so I'm going to work that in right there. Are you, what kind of doctor are you? OBGYN. Obstetrician, I deliver babies. Okay, so, wow, you guys, look how pigmented that purple is right there. I'm in obstetrics and gynecology. That's my field. Okay, so let me take a look. This is a little off a little bit right here. Okay. Okay, do you have Charlotte Tilbury Goddess? Yes, I do. I do have the, well, I have her entire line. I'm thinking I might need that. That is so cool that you deliver baby. My sister is a pediatrician. Aww. You want to become a plastic surgeon? That is a long haul. Is it scary delivering them? It can be. Yes, I do wear makeup every day. I wear makeup pretty much every single day. What's your favorite Tom Ford new eyeshadow quad so far? I'm waiting for Virgin Orchid. We stocked Tom Ford eye quad came on 7th. Okay, my favorite so far has been Leopard Sun. That's my favorite so far. Yeah, Tom Ford instruments. Yeah, that's been the one that I really like. And then what I'll do, what did I use here? I'm going to go back to this shade and kind of blend out what I put in the crease. I forgot to apply this one down to the up to the brow bone anyways. So I'm going to apply that to the brow bone right there and kind of blend that out so it looks a lot softer. And blend that out. See, when are you going to make a makeup collection video? I need an update. I know, I need to do that too. How many years in college did you do? So I did 4 years of undergrad, 4 years of medical school, and 4 years of residency. So 12 years. So, okay, now I am going to use her Pencil Pro brush, and then I'm going to apply this dark brown shade, or dark like plummy brown shade right here. I'm going to apply that to the lower lash line. And smoke it out a little bit. Wow, these brushes are really nice. They really do just do the work for you. So this is like a purpley, it's like a dark purple actually. It looks brown in the pan. It has a little brown in the pan, but it's actually purple. You guys like see that right there? It's like really. Okay. And do that same thing on the other eye as well. Really nice. Which shadows are more luxe, CT or Pat McGrath? I think thank you. Thank you, Mimi. Which shadows are more luxe, CT or Pat McGrath? That's a really hard question. They're both pretty pretty luxe. I personally like Charlotte's formula just a tiny bit better, just because I feel like it lasts longer on me than the Pat McGrath ones. But the Pat McGrath, it's like they're kind of very different because Charlotte has a very different aesthetic than Pat McGrath. I mean, I love both of them, but I think I like Charlotte's just a tiny, tiny, tiny bit more. And then I'm going to go back to using this, what is it called? Builder Pro. And then I don't have my Verimoto switch with me, so I'm just going to. And then I'm going to go into this shade, this sparkly shade right here. And then I'm going to apply that right on the lid, like towards the center right there. You guys see that right there? Oh, that looks really pretty. It has like a really pretty iridescence to it. A bit more dry. What do I do to touch my pen? Yeah, CT1s are a little bit more emollient. I agree with you on that. That's why I think they're like a touch better than the Pat McGrath. But both are really nice. My flesh and cardiology is getting married next summer. She is fair and has dry skin. Which lipsticks would you recommend for the wedding? Are you going to do, if you're going to do like a traditional, well, it depends on what she's, are she going to wear like a white dress? Because lipstick wise, I think that, you know, pretty, really pretty, like pink rose tones are really nice. Charlotte has a lot of nice, pretty rose colored lipsticks. Let's see who else has nice lipsticks. Tom Ford has nice lipsticks, but they don't last very long. Traditional Lila Rose silk dress. So I would go with like more rosy tones. And Charlotte Tilbury has a lot of pretty rosy colored lipsticks. I mean, even Pillow Talk is a really pretty color. Stone Rose is a really pretty color. Yeah, Pat McGrath lipsticks do last a really long time too. I think Pat McGrath has some really beautiful like rose colored lipsticks as well. She has really like a lot of nice ones too. Oh my God, I like the way this eye look is turning out. This is a really good quad. So done with this. Let's see. You're welcome, Tensie, no problem. Now, what's next? Okay, I'm going to line my water lines using, yeah, Stone Rose is a really beautiful color. I'm gonna line my water lines using a new pencil I got from Chanel. This is the Stylo Ombre Contour in Contour Sombre, which is basically number 10, which is basically black. Have you tried Tom Ford satin matte lipsticks? And did you get the Sonia G brush set? Yes, I do. I have the Sonia G, the iPro brush set right here. And this is my first time using them, and I really like them a lot. And I have all her other eye brushes. I am going to pick up her face brushes as well. You like them, Sharon? Yes, I have tried Tom Ford's satin matte lipsticks, and they're really nice, but I refuse to buy Tom Ford lipsticks anymore because they go bad too quickly. So, all right, so I'm gonna apply this to my waterline. And what I do, this is a cool trick, is I use my beauty blender to bring my skin down. I don't actually use my finger to bring my skin down. And then that's how I line my waterline. And always do your bottom waterline before you do the top, because if you do your top first and there's water, it's gonna be hard to apply liner to the bottom. My favorite Dior foundation, favorite cushion foundation. Oh man, oh, I've tried so many cushion foundations. They changed the formula so they don't go bad as quickly anymore. Girl, you sure about that? Yeah, the two styles are awesome. Okay, fine. I mean, Tom Ford, I'm like, oh, I really will want that new lipstick called Fucking Fabulous. It's so nice. Maybe I'll end up getting that one, and that could be the one that it decides whether or not, like, I'll continue buying more lipsticks for him, because he does have, like, the bomb-ass shades. Okay. Woo. I always have to like take a second. You just got it? Oh my God, girl, you gotta like send me a picture of it. Yeah, they took out one type of oil that was going rancid. Okay, so I will get the Fucking Fabulous because I've been wanting it. From Ireland of Indian origin. Oh wow, CT Light Wonder Foundation Shade in the summer and Shade 5 in the winter. Currently, you rock, girl. Yes, I'm an OBGYN. What's your number one moisturizing lip? Lipstick or like lip balm? Like lipstick or lip balm? So lip balm, my favorite lip balm. There's two of them. I like the one by Pharmacy, the Honeybee one that's like 10 bucks. And I love the Laneige lip sleeping mask. Thank you, Laura. Lipstick, favorite moisturizing lip. Oh man, I like Charlotte's lipsticks a lot, especially her Matte Revolution lipsticks. I like Pat McGrath's Luxe Trans lipsticks. I like NARS's Audacious lipsticks. What else? I like the Bite Beauty lipsticks. I like Anastasia Beverly Hills's lip glosses. I'm trying to think what else I have. I like Charlotte's Superstar lips. All right. Now I'm going to have to concentrate real quick because I got to do my upper waterline. Hi, Doma. Oh, and check while you're at it. You're stunning. Oh, thank you. What skincare product is best for acne and scars? Dr. Dennis Gross is really good. Obagi is really good. Drunk Elephant is really good. Has anyone you're delivering a baby for day say, hey, what shadow are you wearing? Yeah. it's always what do you have on your eyes or what perfume are you wearing? That's like the two biggest, most common questions that I get from my patients. I'm trying the new dual lipsticks from T that she signed together. Yeah, I have tried, Laura, I have tried those two lipsticks, the Blush New or Blushing Dream and the other one that she has right now. They're both beautiful. I actually did a video on them back in July, if you want to take a look at that video, because I went over them because they were available during the the Nordstrom anniversary sale. Ooh. Do you hate when you have like an eye booger that like you need to get rid of? Ugh, gross. Okay. Bye, Michelle. I'll check out your live stream in, what time is it right now? Pretty soon, in like 45 minutes or so, we'll check out Michelle's live stream. I'll be joining you soon. Love you, girl. Have you tried the NARS Orgasm Blush and or Afterglow Lip Balm? I just received them today as Christmas gifts. Orgasm Blush, I've been using Orgasm Blush since I was, when it first came out, when I was like in college, I believe. So yeah, I love that blush. It's very, very pretty. It is one of those blushes that emphasizes texture. So just keep that in mind. Did you lick eggs? Who are you? Okay, let's get rid of you. What changed the texture of your skin? The Drunk Elephant For My Day C Serum. And I think, honestly, in the past month, it's been Glow Pro. And you guys can look. My acne scars are looking so much better ever since I started using that product. Why are we talking about eggs? Okay, favorite Pat McGrath red lipstick, Elson. I think that's my favorite, Pat McGrath red lipstick. Okay, so let's do some mascara. So I got a new mascara by Chanel, but I'm not going to use that just yet. I'm going to use my, because I'm waiting for it to be January 1st so I can toss out one of the, So I'm going to toss out one of the mascaras that I'm using right now. So this is just the Chanel Volume de Chanel, the waterproof version. And I don't curl my lashes. So I actually just put the mascara on right away. Favorite brightening serum. I think the Drunk Elephant, the Firma C serum. I think that's my favorite brightening serum. I really like that one a lot. Just Jonah, two things for the recommend. Oh, you're welcome, Tensi. Not a problem. That's what I'm here for. All right. I'm using Sicily Black Rose Cream Mask. And oh, I heard about those. Those are really good. I did. I have like a bunch of like samples of the Sicily Black Rose mask. It's really, really nice. Okay, you guys, I really like the way this eye look came out. What do you think? I mean, it's beautiful. It's really, really pretty. I'm going to do one more coat of Also, the toner is epic. Try that too. The Sicily toner, is it the one that's like in the pink bottle? That looks really nice. Okay. Oh, thank you. You look like a doll, so cute. Oh my God, thank you so much. So we did that. Now, what are we gonna do next? Okay. Let's see, what should we do? What should we do next? Okay, so blush. Okay, so I have a new blush by Chanel. This is the blush in Golden Sun. So let me show it to you guys. This is Golden Sun. Isn't that so pretty? So I'm going to use my Charlotte Tilbury blush brush to apply this. I love the way Chanel blushes smell. It just reminds me of being a little kid. I love blush, you guys. It's so like feminine. Oh, thank you, Mona Lisa. You know, that's what I tell people to remember when they, when I want them to remember my name. I tell them to remember, to just remember Mona Lisa and you won't forget my name. Oh, what a beautiful blush, you guys. Oh, so nice. I really like it a lot. Okay, so that is done. And then let me put this away. Have you tried Chanel brushes? You know, when I was in college, I had a lot of Chanel brushes. Where I find a girlfriend? Not here, bud. So, I used to use them a long time ago, but they're different now. They're a lot more softer now. But I used to use them all the time back in the day. And I had a whole collection of them at that time. You like that, Mimi? Okay, so what's next? Okay. I got this other thing from, I should have probably put this one on before I put on the blush, but that's okay. This is the Chanel Le Beige Healthy Glow Sheer Color Stick. So it's kind of like a stick product where, look how pretty this, I love this packaging. It's so nice. And then you actually apply this as either a kind of like a bronzer blush mix, which kind of would work on my skin tone. So that's what kind of I was thinking of doing, but I shouldn't have done that probably. That's okay. We'll add that right here. We can put that on top a little bit. Just to give it a little bit more dimension. The number 20 stick is the number 20 stick. Yes, that's this one. Isn't this so pretty, Sharon? I'm going to apply a little bit more here. So you kind of just made it a little bit more darker, a little bit more brighter. It's really, really pretty. And I really like the way, it smells so good too. Like that's that. And then as a highlighter. This was one of my disappointing products because, but I've been using it as a highlighter and actually liked it as a highlighter. Oh, thank you. This is the Laura Mercier Translucent Loose Setting Powder in Glow. I would not use this as a setting powder unless you want to look like you have like shine all over you. So I actually have been using this instead. Hi, Lorraine. How are you? Hi, Millie. You're not too late. No worries. Don't worry about it. So I'm going to use this instead as a highlighter. It actually works really well as a highlighter. So you see that right there. It works well as a highlighter. I don't know how I can't wear this as a setting powder. It's too shimmery. So you guys can kind of see it's like a subtle, pretty like shine, but it's actually really nice. I like it. I like it the way that is right there. It's really pretty. Okay, so then just kind of a little bit down the bridge of my nose. So my nose is still like healing right here. So I sometimes forget and I like knock my hand into it and I'm like, oh! Like even when I'm doing this right now, I need to be careful. Yes, I got that part as well thinking it might give me a glow, but it's only good as highlight. Yeah, it really is because It's just weird all over your face. Hi, Rena from London. Are you using Wake Up or 7 Up to makeup? Are you, huh? Okay, hi from London. Found you last week and love your Charlotte Soul reviews and get ready with me videos. I've been binge watching all your videos this week. Awesome. Hi, Lisa. How are you? Okay, so we got that, and then let's do lips. So I thought, I was going back and forth about what to use for the lips, and I was like, why not just go ahead and apply the Lisa Eldridge in the Velvet Jazz color? I don't know, what do you guys think? Does that look weird? Oh, awesome. You're a midwife? So cool. So you understand the love for obstetrics then. What do you guys think? Does that look weird? Or should I just give it a try? So, and then I'm going to apply it with a lip liner in Walk of Shame by Charlotte. Okay, cool. So let's give it a try. Yeah, let's give it a try. Why not? Because people always do want to do like a nude lip with purple. So I'm like, let me do something a little bit different. So I remember when you used to do all Charlotte Tilbury looks and through you got, Sean, how do you keep those videos coming? Happy New Year to you and your family. Oh, thank you so much. Her lipsticks sold out. I know they sold out real fast. I was literally on labor and delivery when they went on sale and I purchased them off of my phone. I was like watching tracings of my patients in labor. And then I was like, oh my God, I better buy these right now before they sell out. So that's exactly what I did. So let me line my lips. I heard she is going to probably restock next year for next fall, next holiday. I don't think there's going to be a restock anytime soon, which really sucks for those who didn't get to purchase them. Okay. So I got my lip liner on. Now I'm going to apply the lipstick straight from the bullet. I mean, look at that pigmentation, like, right away. All right, guys, what do you think? Does it look really weird? Let me bring my hair down. I'm gonna get like the whole look. Oh, by the way, you guys, scrunchies are back in. Have you tried? Oh, the Tom Ford foundation stick is awesome. I really, really like it a lot. Oh, my hair is like a mess today. Sorry. Oh, very pretty. Thank you. Oh, I have a question for you guys. So there's this product by Fido. Thank you, Millie. There's a product by Fido called Fido, like 30 something, where it claims, oh, thank you, Rena. It claims that it helps reduce your gray hairs from coming, and it helps reverse gray hair. So I wanted to, in like gray hair is something that I've, well, I just got my hair color, so I don't have any gray right now, but gray hair is something that I get, and I was wondering if you guys would be interested. It's going to be like a little bit of a long process because it takes 3 months for it to kind of start kicking in, but I wanted to know if you guys think it would be worth me doing a like full review on this particular product, because I know gray hair is like the bane of a lot of our existence. I personally hate it when my grays come out and I try to cover them up. Oh, thanks. Yeah, I'm actually really happy with this hair length too. Like, I'm happy that I decided to cut my hair, and I like having it a little bit shorter. I feel like it's more, a little bit more work, but I still like it. Oh, so we'd like you to give it a try. Yeah, I'm going to try it. Oh, I forgot to tell you guys. I got the Dyson Airwrap. So let me know if you want me to also do a video. Actually, my grandmother tried it and her hair, gray hair started becoming less. Is that the Sicily Hair Care Serum? Oh, thank you, Bertha. So should I do the Fido, give it a try? And do you guys want to see me do a video on the Dyson Airwrap? Because I just got it not too long ago and I haven't started using it yet. And I want to know, if, unless you guys are like sick of seeing all of the reviews on the Dyson Airwrap, then I won't do it. But if you guys are interested in seeing it, I really need it for me and my mom, please. Okay. Is that, which one, Ina? Are you talking about the gray hair thing or the Dyson Airwrap? Oh, thank you. Her lips, I really like her lipsticks. They're so nice. For the Dyson is worth it. Yeah, I mean, that's why I went ahead and got it. The gray hair. Yeah, I'm going to give the gray hair solution a try. I mean, the product a try. I'll buy it today on Dermstore tonight and get it so I can start using it. Because I got my hair colored maybe a few weeks ago, so they're not coming in just yet. But I'm going to give it a try and see if it actually works. So, and then I'll do like a review to let you guys know. Oh, thank you. All right, guys. So I'm ready. I'm all done. I did my makeup and I really enjoyed doing this live stream with you guys. Oh, thank you. Doing this live stream with you guys and sitting down and just chatting and talking about stuff and this just shooting the shit with you guys. Yeah, I'll definitely check that one out. Thank you, Mo. Of course, you're so welcome. And then I know a lot of you guys wanted to know what was left from my makeup sale last week. So what I will do is I'm going to post a list. Bye, Sharon. I'm going to post a list of all the things that are still available so you guys can take a look and see if there's anything else that you guys wanted. But I really enjoyed talking to you guys, and maybe we'll do this again. It's probably gonna be a while before I can do it again, probably sometime in January. But we'll make it, Oh, the winner for the Charlotte Tilbury giveaway, I'm going to be announcing it on Christmas. So just keep that in mind. And I will see you guys. I think I already sold the Natasha Denona number 8 palette. So I'm sorry about that. But it was a pleasure talking to all of you guys as well. I love you guys. You guys are awesome. And we're going to do this again probably in about a month or so. And happy holidays to you guys. Merry Christmas. A happy new year. And I'll see you guys all very soon. Mwah. Love you guys. Bye.